Did you know that sleep has a lot to do with your telomere length? It does. In fact, sleep has been associated with a lot of things which drive health and longevity. Chronic sleep loss has been associated with Alzheimer's, cancer, diabetes. In fact, with diabetes, you have a bad night of sleep and you have insulin resistance the next 2 days. Any guess what that might be? Maybe cortisol. Depression, immune dysfunction, hypertension, all of these things are associated with chronic sleep loss. Telomere shortening has also been associated with shortened lifespan, and sleep loss has been associated with telomere shortening. Even short-term sleep loss has been associated with decreased gene expressions in terms of healthy genes and biomarkers. Here's one of the studies. Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, a good space. Effects of insufficient sleep on circadian rhythmicity and expression amplitude in human blood transcriptome. Again, what they're showing is we change the genes that we express based on how well we sleep. Here's another one. In PLOS, short sleep duration is associated with shorter telomere length in healthy men. Findings from the Whitehall 2 cohort study. What is a telomere anyway? It's the end cap on a chromosome, and it has something to do with our body's ability and the chromosome's ability to find specific gene locations, pull that gene out, and actually translate that gene into RNA, and then RNA and proteins, genes, enzymes, things like that. The shorter your telomere, the shorter your projected lifespan. Here's another one in Oxford Sleep, association between snoring and leukocyte telomere length. Well, now, wait a minute. We thought we were talking about sleep. Snoring is the ultimate Jack the Ripper's hiding behind so many of us. We don't realize when we're asleep. People that have sleep disordered breathing, sleep apnea, you may notice that you wake up, but you don't notice what woke you up. Quite often it was snoring or sleep apnea or sleep disordered breathing, all the same thing. And what that's doing is waking you up when your body is trying to reconstruct and restore hormone levels for important hormones, like lower levels of cortisol. You continue to get interrupted with sleep disorders and you continue to have negative impacts on your health. If you haven't read this book, a little bit foggy looking, sorry about that. Actually, this is not a book. This is a video by Matt Walker, Secrets of the Sleeping Brain. He covers a lot of this telomere length and sleep issue. The book I was remembering is also by Matt Walker. It's Why We Sleep. Excellent book. If you've made it this far, thank you for your interest. My name is Ford Brewer. I started off my career as an ER doc, and that can be frustrating, because most of the things bringing patients into the ER can and should be prevented, like heart attack and stroke. So I went to Johns Hopkins for training in prevention, did well, ended up running the program, trained dozens of docs there, and have trained hundreds and even over 1,000 doctors since then in preventing disease. What's even more important is I've helped thousands of patients prevent heart attack and stroke rather than waiting for the devastation and hoping for a cure.